All right, so we just set it down. And we have the brakes bled. We have the new lines in. We might have to bleed the brakes again, but I need to just finish cleaning up a couple things here. Over here, it's a little bit wet, and I gotta figure out why. Could just be like something squirting brake fluid when I squirt. I don't know. But let's see here. The whole front lines, all the way back to the T in the back. Those are all, that's all new brake line. So, yeah. I think I'm done for the day. The sun is right at the horizon, pretty much. Yeah. So, yeah, tomorrow I have to start looking at that and seeing if that is leaking at all. And basically what that is, it's this right here. I have two of them. I ordered two because I didn't know one came with the other kit. So the rear brakes are this one right here. You can see it down there. The rear brakes go that one. And then these here are for the fronts. And yeah, so I don't know, maybe I didn't get a good seating inside it. That's always a possibility, not getting a good seat. So I guess I gotta play with it, see if I can get it seated better and no leaks. And if that's a possibility, then yeah, I can close up the fender. Once I get that done, the fender gets closed up. Of course, I gotta try and start it and drive it. Getting closer. When I changed the spark plug wires, I'm pretty sure I got the right order, but I have to double check it before I try and start it. And then nearly the entire fuel system's been gone through, except for the fuel pump down there. So, I might need a new fuel pump, but I think, you know, I mean, it was working before, so why shouldn't it keep on working, right? Yeah, so, I gotta put the wires back on the, double check the wire order. And I can start it. I got the battery. Although these battery cables are ugly. That's ugly. Look at that. Is it? Whatever. This is it for today. Signing. Okay. So. We have reached a special point where we're allowed to actually add stuff that we ordered from the unboxing. Yes. Carpet. Let's see if it actually is the color that we want. Yeah, I looked a little bit, but I didn't open it up. So, as soon as we get the carpet all in there, the seats go in. So, let's see here. The carpet is going to need to lay out in the sun for a little while to get used to things, I guess. Supposedly, this carpet is supposed to include where's that? Okay.
see what we've got. Back.
Okay, so we're gonna let the carpet lay out here. It's supposed to uncrinkle, I guess. And then, while it's doing that, we'll start ripping this out. Finish this. Let's take a look at it here. Got that in. Everything that's good in there. Yeah, all looks great. I found this huge bag of parts that my father had bought. Oof. There's so much inside it. It's like, oh my God. You know, there's things that I bought, that he bought, that I bought. So I got like doubles of some of these stuff. Like those light lenses. He bought some. And of course we had two cars at the time. So there's like doubles of doubles. Anyways. The brakes are all done. All the parts are on the brakes now. And I bled the brakes. So at this point, there's only minor things holding me up. Yeah. And look, my father had bought a dome light. There's already a dome light up there. That's just how it is. That's for the gas tank. I guess I got a new mirror. I have to figure out if that looks good or not. That one's okay. Maybe. And that one's kind of big and it's got a rubber on the outside that I don't really care for.
Excuse me.
Oh, okay. So another thing that we've got to do here is we've got a window regulator here. I mean, not the regulator, the washer. Windshield washer. Yeah. Wiper motor. So, I personally would have put the 2-speed, which is what I did to the other El Camino I had. Had a 2-speed on it. And, but you know, Dad bought that one. That's a thingy.
Oh, yeah. This is going to be heavy. You're going for a ride.
This on. If you don't know what this is, it's a kick plate for the passenger side where the air conditioning meets. And of course, since I took out the air conditioning and restored everything that I could over there, I had to take that off. Yeah. Took me a long, long, long time to work on that. And it's still not even completely finished. They don't have the compressor on it. There's parts on the unit I sent out to be disassembled, and the person never returned it. And I'm less than happy about that result. There's always a person that, you know, would take care of things, but I don't know, he's not as happy anymore. Okay, so see, these are the plates that I made to use for the seats. That one will go through. Okay. Almost got everything. Alright, where's the little magnetics? Okay, so now I think all I need to do is remove that, take that up. What time is it? I have something to do. I want to do at 5. Computer, what time is it?
The time is 4:38 p.m.
Ooh, I gotta go inside. All right, I'm gonna pause this for now. I mean, that carpet's got to sit in the sun anyway, so we'll just have to pick up again tomorrow since I have a video game I have planning to play with friends. Yeah. You okay, dog? What's up? What's up? What do you think? It's dirty. Yeah. Dirty carpet, but I got clean carpet out here. Okay, we're coming along quite nicely now. I have laid the carpet out in here. Had to remove the old carpet. I've cut the hole for the transmission shift. Yes, it's the shift housing. I've cut the hole for the pedal. I installed the pedal. And I cut a hole for the brights. So all we have to do now is install the seats, and these are the brackets for the seats. So some of them have to protrude through. Then I also have to make holes for the seat belts. And that's where we're at right now. It took a lot of rolling around in here, and it was really tiring. And, so I'm done for the day. But it's coming along quite nicely now. Maybe tomorrow I'll get the seats in. Yeah. See, after the seats get in, you know, the carpet's fully installed, the seats are in. I mean, what else is there to do but to start it? Yeah. Then, of course, you know, when I get it started and running, I'm gonna take it in and get the new mufflers put on it. And I bought these mufflers a little while ago. Dynomat. I have no idea if they're any good or not. I did hear them on a YouTube channel. They sounded good to me. So I think they're the right size. At least I think that's, yeah, pretty sure the right size. And, yeah, I'm just going to get some to install them, and that's the next thing after, after that. But, yeah, still got to install this here. I might do that soon, I don't know. So, I have to look at it. Get these reinstalled as soon as the carpet and the seats are in. I don't know if I mentioned it before, but these seats came out of a Nissan. You can like it or not like it if you want. I don't care. I happen to love these seats. I have a pair of them in my Nissan. And they are the most comfortable seats ever. And they fit. So, yeah, hopefully tomorrow I'll get those seats in the car. And, there's still a compressor down there I've got to get installed, but the rest of the air conversion, air stuff isn't installed either, so. Yeah, almost all done now. Yeah, of course. Just happy, aren't you, dog? How's it going? Yeah. So, this replaces that. It's Should be fine. Yeah, I have to take these out. This will take a little while. Maybe get that done next week. Very close. Very close to doing stuff here. So, I have finished getting the seats in and the new carpet. I still have to build a console, put it in there. I think I'm going to build a console out of walnut. It will go from a forward position up there near the vent on the bottom floor and then come back down there. In the back, I'm thinking about putting just boards or a board. I don't know. It's just basically I'm going to board it up. To hide the back section. And actually at this point right now, everything's good to go. Although I think I have a leaky brake line over here. Down there. Not sure exactly what I'm gonna do about that or what the problem is at, but we can turn it on. And it should run, hopefully. There you go. Oh, that sounds great. I don't think the water temperature is working. Yeah, I really don't think the water temperature is working. It pretty much goes straight to the floor. Now, I bled the brakes like I don't know how many times since I put the new line in, and it's still giving me, I don't know. I personally think it needs to be more pedal, but here it stops completely. I'm probably going to have to bleed the brakes again. That doesn't sound right. That's the parking brake. Looks like you guess. The fuel gauge doesn't appear to be working. Now, I put a new fuel gauge in there, and it should be working. There should also be 10 gallons in there right now. Well,
probably have to take the dash out so I can do that.
Anyways.
Let's see here. Got an exhaust leak.
By the way, if you want to know what condition the original chairs were in, this is the bottom. See how the feet were rusted off. And this wasn't originally the chair that was in there. I think it was originally a bench. Usually they have benches in them. And I don't know what these were out of. Probably something. Maybe 68, 66, I don't know. The other one's up there. I suppose I might sell it. If I can find someone that will buy it. So, at this point, it's like completely, I don't know, I mean, it should be done, but I still have worries about the brake leak, and the brakes in general, and then I've got some wires in there to sort out. This should work. Be able to. So, yeah. Let's see if we can get her to just play nicely. Thank you. Alright, let's see if we can turn it around.
forward. And stop. That's not too bad. And stop. Forward. And stop. To our alley. Let's go ahead and check it out and look at the fluids, see if anything changed while I was gone. Where's the button? Where's the button? There's the button. So far, so good. I'm gonna check the fluids and yeah, I'd like it to stop a little bit better, but the brake pedal is totally there. I mean, we got brake pedal now. My water temperature still is not working. But I'm not really afraid of it. It's never had a problem before, and when I was lasering it, everything was good. So. So you can see right here, there's definitely some unhappy, you know, panel there, but it's fine. I have more unhappiness about something like that than I have about that. I don't really care. It's okay. And of course the tailgate is probably the worst of all the, there's a nasty right there. There's another tailgate over there, but like I said, it doesn't really bother me all that much. Yeah, she's a little rough, but compared to how it was before, oh, it's night and day. Believe me, night and fucking day. definitely got some scratches that I could take care of. Yeah, okay. It was running really well driving in the alley there. I do seem to have brake pedal. I don't see any fluid leaking. It's a little wet, but I don't know. Okay. Let's check the transmission fluid. One's shiny. That's for sure.
You're the doll one.
And the Ford.
All the Fords.
We're out right. Caddy. Another caddy. This is a that's a caddy too. There you go, look at that one right there. The green. This is a green. Not sure what that one is. It's very orange. Very orange. Purple top.
And I mean, there's
that one.
Believe it or not, that is actually one of my favorite
years. Speed line.
I know, right? Wait, why did you see that?
Oh. That's an interesting back end. Impala? Oh, look at the little buggy. That's nice and old. That thing is like pretty old. Be up, huh? Back up. That orange truck. Let's go this way. They got Christmas trees in here. The back end right there. Bill O'Reilly. Crazy man right there. Yeah. It's interesting shape. I definitely like the shape. I do really like the way that this one looks here. Although it's too dark right now. Too dark. More caddies. Bel Air leaving. Stickers on that car. That's a Nova. No. Well, look at that one. Of course, you can't see it because the sun's in the way. Well, it's for sale. It's pretty. Take a look around here and see if there's anything hiding in the background here. There's more trucks. Let's see here. There's an old truck over there. Here's an old truck here. 1960 C10, right? Apache 10. With a step. Alright. Oh, and look. Is that a Rolls Royce? That looks like a Rolls Royce there. Or Mercedes? I don't know. Jasmine. Old car. Okay, what's this here? 1951. Yeah, that sucks. Car doesn't start. It's not something we want to not happen, or to whatever. 1951. Sprayway. Better not be my sprayway. Ford. What's he got here? That's nice. And we're back to our car.
There we go.
The Ford. Anyway. Nice interiors in some of them. Yep. Oh, there's the only other El Camino here. Oh, God, my stomach is full. Looks like they've co-opted the Jiffy Lube parking. Huh.
Yeah. They're co-oping the Jiffy Lube.
Do, 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 do. Good thing my battery's low. Excuse me. Let's see here. That's a 1940s, 30s. Did you get that? A little dance going on over there. I like that red car. That's nice. That's good. Anyways, my stomach is so full, I gotta go home. There's a lot of people though today. Yeah. In the shade though. All right, time to go home. Ba ba da 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 da. That is front lights are very weird. Do 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 do